What could happen if a woman uses Rogaine for men, extra strength? It says dangerous, not for use by women.
Thank you for your question. You're asking about the use of minoxidil extra strength for men, and is it safe for women? I'm sure it's for the problem you're dealing with, which is most likely female pattern hair loss. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance with this question. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon, fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon, and I'm also the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, a procedure we've developed in our practice that's a non-surgical alternative for hair loss for men and women. So I certainly have a lot of experience with the use of minoxidil. In this country, minoxidil and finasteride are the two drugs that are FDA approved for men, and minoxidil is FDA approved for women. Now, hair loss, which 95% of the time is referred to as familial or pattern hair loss, and also called androgenetic alopecia, is basically a progressive thinning of hair. The hair starts out thick, and eventually, as it sheds, it grows in, gets thinner, and then continues to thin until it stops growing altogether, and the area becomes smooth and is only skin. So minoxidil certainly has had a role in the management of hair loss, but it's important to understand that minoxidil does not stop hair loss and does not stop the progression. In my experience, it appears that minoxidil basically prolongs the growth cycle of thinning hairs. Now, in this country currently, there is an FDA-approved 5% foam minoxidil for women. And from my experience, 5% is adequate for its purpose. Now, this certainly, we have tried compounding minoxidil and combining higher percentages with retinols and other agents to help improve the topical treatment. But what we've done in our practice is basically eliminate majority of the indication for minoxidil because we've developed something called hair regeneration. With hair regeneration, what we're doing is we're using a material called extracellular matrix combined with your own blood, a part of your blood called platelet-rich plasma. And essentially, we're doing what you want to try to do with minoxidil, except we're doing something more. What we've been able to do is stop the progression of hair loss, reactivate hair that is not growing, as well as get or correct the hair growth cycle so that instead of thinning, the hairs actually grow thicker. Now, for women in our practice, we have achieved more comparably 99% success. Now, this is something that's evolved over years where for women, we initially had numbers like 80% success, but what we did was with time, we basically limited who we treated to just female pattern hair loss and eliminated the types of patients who have other problems such as chronic telogen effluvium. Now, what that means is that within 12 to 15 months, most of our patients, both men and women, will see significant improvement with this treatment, which often is a single treatment. Sometimes there's more than one injection separated by over a year. But in essence, I think that there's opportunity to consider alternatives besides just thinking of stronger minoxidil. One of the challenges we had when we would compound higher strength minoxidil was scalp irritation, and patients just didn't want to continue using something that caused their scalp to be irritated. Remember that the minoxidil originally was a drug used for hypertension, for high blood pressure. A side effect was seeing hair growth. So I'm not saying it doesn't have value, But for most of our patients who use minoxidil, once we do hair regeneration treatment, we have them stop. But to going back to answering your original question, as far as extra strength is concerned, and from my perspective, 5% minoxidil for women is adequate. As a side note, I would say that most of the women who we see in our practice will have tried minoxidil in the past and will have stopped using minoxidil because they felt it really wasn't doing much for them. You know, it's one thing to try to hold on to the hair, and it's kind of a weird uncertainty whether or not the minoxidil is being effective. And for many patients, they just feel like they're not seeing enough of a difference to justify the twice daily use of minoxidil as recommended by the manufacturer. But I personally believe there is a role prior to someone having a treatment like hair regeneration. So again, I think that if you want to use 5% minoxidil foam, I think that will probably be adequate. If you want to learn more about hair regeneration and find a practitioner who offers this type of procedure, learn more about that as well. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.